people.
Hello.
How do? It's me, Marconi, and Sierra Cake. And yes, today on our show, on Marconi One, we told you how to win the ultimate Coachella connection. And if you didn't listen, you should probably go tune in now. Because
Or go to sleep. Because it's over. It's done.
No, it's not over.
Oh.
It's going to be a while before we get a winner.
Oh.
Do you think by the time this podcast is posted, we've already had a winner?
I don't know. Maybe.
Sometimes
people are like, they're a little bit nutso.
Well, we'll see. Okay. If somebody already won and we're posting this now, and because, you know, we put this podcast together and maybe somebody did win.
Then they cheated.
Cheater. So I don't know. You'll have to, stay tuned. Find out. Check out our show on Marconi One. That's kind of how we cross promote. You know what I mean? We tease you here to listen there, and then we tease you there to listen here, and then everybody wins.
Just there's a lot of teasing everywhere.
yes. But we did do a show, and I hope you enjoy it. Thank you for tuning in for another Me Plus Cake podcast.
Me Plus Cake. Marconi One. Radio for the people.
It is a pleasant spur to the morning's work.
We watch Netflix all the time, and most of the time it's really hard to find stuff to stick with on Netflix that we both enjoy. Like, we like horror films.
Yes.
Or, dramatical adventure type movies. I kind of knew about this show. I thought, oh, it looks interesting. But you know how most new shows look. They always tell you how great they are right up front.
Uh-huh.
You never believe it. And I like Kevin Bacon, but I didn't know. He had the new show called The Following. And I was like, that looks kind of good. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
But we watched it. It's freaking amazing.
Oh, my God.
I just slobbered.
You know what else is amazing?
What?
This popsicle I'm eating.
Well, I'm glad you could be distracted by that. But The Following, okay, so Kevin Bacon plays an ex-FBI agent.
Yes.
He's got a drinking problem.
Yes.
He wakes up with vodka in his water bottle.
Oh, God, that's so ridiculous.
And then he's got a pacemaker.
Mm-hmm.
So he's got
those, stabbed in the heart.
Yeah, those are his things. Like, that's his stuff.
There's always something with these cops.
Like, if he's a superhero, he's got something wrong with him, and these are the things.
Yep.
And I guess, you know, like, you learn about his dad and that kind of stuff. But the whole scenario is, like, this guy creates this cult following, and he's behind bars, and he's Kevin Bacon's arch nemesis. And if you liked 24, you will like this times 20. It's awesome.
So good.
Yeah, so I highly recommend, if you haven't watched it already, the first season of The Following with Kevin Bacon and a bunch of other actors you'll probably recognize from different stuff. Everybody is deceiving.
You can't trust anyone.
Yeah, don't trust anyone on this show. That's all I can say.
Don't ever trust anyone ever.
I don't want to. Right. You just stopped. You probably shouldn't even trust us. We could be lying to you right now about The Following.
Maybe we are.
Maybe it's awful. We don't know. You can't tell unless you watch it. So, check it out on Netflix, The Following. And tell them Me Plus Cake sent you. Sorry.
They met on the internet, and now they're on Marconi One. It's Me Plus Cake. Radio for the people.
You know, it's almost impossible for the regular human with a regular job to go to the Super Bowl unless you've been saving all year or whatever. Because when they started out, a hotel room was going to cost like $2,000. Tickets would be like, you know, a couple grand. And that's not including like any time. Like, you're in New York, you're going to buy food, go to restaurants, check out everything during the week if you go there.
The Super Bowl's in New York?
What?
The Super Bowl's in New York?
Yeah.
Oh.
You know who's playing this year?
Let's
see if she knows.
You
really not know?
Yes. The Seahawks and the frickin' Broncos.
Right. The frickin' Broncos is right. You mean the next Super Bowl champions?
Uh-huh.
But I guess a couple of hotel places have lowered their prices down quite considerably. From like 2,000 to like 300.
Why did they do that?
Well, because it's getting closer and they wanted to get all the premiums right away. And they realized they don't have any room. So some of these brokers, you know, like you go through a website like hotels.com or one of these websites and you get good deals. Now all the deals are happening.
Well, Jesus.
So yeah, I guess that's now's the time to go if you're thinking about it and we're on the fence. But then, you know, like some people like to just go. I guess they're not even allowing you to tailgate at this Super Bowl.
What does that mean?
You never heard of tailgating either?
No.
I guess in Canada, it's probably too cold to do all that stuff. It'll probably be too cold in the...
Oh, like when you sit on a truck?
Yeah, when you just sit in a truck drinking beer?
Yeah.
Well, like, you know, all the football commercials where they show the guys, like, grilling
that seems,
out...
Yeah, that seems really redneck.
It does?
Yeah.
Is it beneath you? Are you too good for that?
No, I'm not too good. I'm just saying.
Right. So if I was into that, you would be in. You'd go like, whatever, I'll do it.
Yeah, but I wouldn't wear like a cowboy hat or anything like that. This chair is gonna break. I feel.
Are you? Do you think that you have to wear a cowboy hat to go to a tailgate party for a football game?
Yeah.
Why?
You have to drink beer and you have to eat
raw beef.
Yeah. You have to eat burgers. Some corn on the cob.
Me plus Kate. Marconi One. Radio for the people.
I guess there's a guy, a clerk with a fake name, and he stole $10,000 from a convenience store and then disappeared.
What?
Yeah, in Spokane.
What a genius.
You're like, how can I figure out how to do this?
I know. Did he get caught?
Well, he's on camera, and... I don't know. His coworkers say his name is Josh Canterbury.
My God, you know what I would do?
What?
Put on a wig. And, like, not do my eyebrows. Right. I wouldn't do my makeup at all because I look so different without makeup.
And then
never wear anything that revealed my tattoos.
I see.
You would never know. You would never know it was me.
He stole $3,200 in cash plus cigarettes and other goods.
Jeez.
So if you only got how did that add up to $10,000? That's a lot of merchandise if he stole that much. Wow.
That doesn't seem accurate.
I know. I mean, there's only...
Unless he, like, hit multiple stores or
how
something.
Much ice cream is in that store? Or maybe liquor or something. I don't know. I think in Washington you could buy beer there.
Oh, gosh.
So, I don't know. So, you like the idea.
That's, like, the most exciting thing to happen to Spokane in, like... Have you been to Spokane? Oh my God. If you want to go antique shopping, maybe.
Marconi Bologna. Sierra Cake. Me plus Cake. Marconi One. Radio for the people.
The Bubble Wrap Hall of Fame.
What?
Why do they even have a Bubble Wrap Hall of Fame? Like, what could that even be about?
Oh, Lord.
I don't understand. They induct a guy from Burbank for doing something weird. I guess he gets... like a big wad of bubble wrap on his bike, and then he runs over it and pops it while it's rolling out underneath him.
I really don't like the word wad.
Who said wad?
You did.
Oh, I would have said wad of bubble wrap?
Yeah.
You're focusing on the wrong thing. This is the stupidest thing ever.
Oh.
The Bubble Wrap Hall of Fame?
It's, yep.
I mean,
people love bubble wrap, though.
I do, too, but what would you put in a Hall of Fame? I guess... when I think of a Hall of Fame, I think of like an actual place that you would go and look at things.
Yep.
But it's not really that, is it? You don't go to a Bubble Wrap Hall of Fame and see anything. It's like an honored thing. Like, hey, I'm in the Bubble Wrap Hall of Fame. I'm the guy that rides the bike over the bubble wrap. I figured out a way.
Okay.
Who else is in the Bubble Wrap Hall of Fame, though? Regular people who get lots of packages?
Yeah.
I mean, I guess you could be. You get a package every day.
No, I don't.
And you can step on the bubble wrap and film it and send it in.
That's weird.
Well, I just don't get it. But this guy, I don't know, from the Bubble Wrap Hall of Fame, delighted the judges. And he got like 15,000 yards of bubble wrap and just ran over it with his bike.
Well, get on you, bro.
While other people at work earning a living, this guy.
Yes, congratulations.
Brother, that next morning.
Me plus Cake.
I never felt worse.
Marconi won. Radio for the people.
Obama gave the State of the Union address last night.
Right.
And since you're from Canada, that just means he gives an update on how things are going.
Okay.
And the Republicans and the Democrats sit in a room, and the Democrats, or they stand up and clap for Obama, and the Republican, they sit with their arms folded and frown. Ugh. Like big babies.
Yes.
So even if Obama's like, and we got back 20% more jobs in this quarter, go America, yay! The Republicans will sit there and frown.
Yep.
And we provided you with blah, 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 and we did this. And they're just... Mwah.
You know what they remind me of, politicians? All of them?
Oh, you're waiting for me to say yes. What?
They remind me. They remind me of a bunch of girls, because girls are never happy for each other.
Right.
They're always snarky, and they're always mean, and they're always, there's something wrong with the, what, no matter who it is, the other girls are just mad about
everything.
Yeah,
that's what always holds.
You could freaking cure AIDS and cancer and make world peace and save every kitten in the entire universe.
Well, I mean,
they would still be like, no. That's
I would say basic people are like that, but there are intelligent women in the world that aren't like that.
Women? Well, yeah,
women,
not every
men,
girl,
everybody,
but
you know
what I'm saying.
You were talking
though.
About women, so that's what I was talking about.
Yeah, girls are, they just like, if you go on Instagram and you look at like a popular girls like Kim Kardashian or whoever. There's
an example of vapidity at its best,
yeah,
right there.
Yeah, but that's not. It's just an example.
But the kind of people that are going to be on
her webpage.
But
why? Like, what is the point of it? Like, I don't understand why. Like, why aren't they working together and helping each other instead of bringing each other down? I just don't get it.
Yes.
Politicians is what I'm talking about. Politics.
Yes.
Instead of saying
that... Let's just hope that when Kim Kardashian becomes president that we're all dead.
Yeah.
Find Me Plus Cake on Pinterest, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and more. Click the cake button on MarconiOne.com. Radio for the people.
Here's an update. You know, the teacher that was taken off duty or fired or whatever, temporarily on leave for having racy photos of herself.
Uh-huh.
I guess they decided that the photos weren't that bad and that she could come back to work.
Of course. Good. It's discriminatory.
Yeah, I mean, she's basically on some ski-doo with some pants and a bikini top on.
People are such prudes.
And by the way, she's very lovely.
Oh.
What? Am I supposed to notice that?
Good to know.
I'm dead inside, not on the outside.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I think most of the time, don't you think it's that the girl's attractive? Like, if they weren't pretty, the school would care less.
Yeah.
But it's like the guys in charge are like, oh, wow, I don't want to be attracted to one of my teachers. That's wrong.
Oh, my God.
You know what I mean? So then they get all, like, old school about it, and they're weird. Like, it's their daughter or something. Have you ever had that discrimination before? Like, somebody be weird because you look pretty, and they're like, ah, I don't want you to be, you should put more clothes on.
Yeah, actually, I have. Not to be full of myself. But
really?
Mm-hmm.
Where did it happen?
There was a place that I worked at, and all the girls would say weird things to me, like make snide remarks about my size, mostly, is what it was.
Oh, because you're tiny?
Mm-hmm. And I would eat, like, poutines all the time, and they would be, like, very not nice about it.
Oh, yeah. Like, this is a thing that I think is weird, because Sierra weighs, like, 100 pounds soaking wet, and she's... what you say, the blessed metabolism.
Mm-hmm.
But she's not the kind of girl that's like, you know, oh yeah, look at me, I look better, I could get your boyfriend.
Well, yeah, no.
I hope she's not like that. Anyway, but you always have had people in your life that have been weird like that about it. Like they might be a little bit overweight or, you know, whatever, not happy with themselves.
Mm-hmm.
And then they'll give you a hard time about it.
It's so rude. Like, I don't understand why it's not acceptable to call someone fat. But to call somebody too skinny or say constantly comment on how skinny someone is just as rude, in my opinion.
Well, and also, I guess you would eat, like, fries with gravy. And they would be like, oh, that must be nice to be able to eat all that all the time.
Yeah, like, oh, you're so skinny, Sierra. It's rude. I don't like it. It makes me really upset when people say that. I think it's so rude.
And a lot of people would take that as a compliment. Like, if people call me skinny,
No, it's not. If you say, like, oh, you have a really good body, or you're really fit, or you're really in shape, or that's a compliment. But saying somebody is skinny is not. It's rude.
I think you look hot.
Thank you.
There you go. Well, I have to say that, but I would say that even if I didn't have to.
Thanks.
I'm obligated. I'm contractually obligated to say that.
Just be careful of your use of words.
Right.
Some people, I would never say that. I would never call someone fat.
Right.
Because it's rude.
You can think it, though. I can see you think it. You're looking at me. Don't look at me like that. I'm not.
How dare you? I'm not even looking at you.
See? Wish somebody would just catfish me right now.
Me plus cake. Marconi One.
Lambs are gathering for the work of a new day.
Radio for the people.
A mattress falls off a vehicle and causes a fatal car accident.
Oh, no.
Is the person liable for murder that didn't strap the mattress down good enough?
No. No. That's horrible.
But if they would have done what you're supposed to do, strapping it down properly and stuff like that, it wouldn't have flown off.
But how do we know that it wasn't, and it wasn't just an accident?
Well, I guess they'll have to investigate and find out.
Oh, that would be awful, though.
Yeah. Death by mattress.
Ugh.
Mattresses are supposed to bring joy and happiness into your life, not death.
Mine doesn't.
What do you mean?
It hurts my spine.
My bed?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm sorry. That's a glorious bed.
I feel it.
Many people would love to be in that bed.
It's just, I can't do memory foam. I like really
hard beds.
Of course,
you found a way to complain about the best bed I've ever had in my entire life.
Okay, well, see ya.
But that said, like, you know, I guess it's weird when you think about it. Because people relax in bed. They sleep in bed. Some people die in bed.
Ew.
But being killed by a mattress? Nobody wants to go out like that.
No, that's awful.
But people,
wait, or do they, though?
Maybe. In their sleep, probably. No, but you know what is crazy is when you think about it, a lot of people do this. If you see people on the highway right driving down the road with bunches of furniture and not strapped in properly,
yes.
People are idiots.
Things are flying out all over the place.
Yeah.
It's worse when they have garbage or like hay or something.
Oh, yeah.
And it's all flying all over the place. And they just are completely oblivious.
Even when somebody does have it all strapped down properly, I still avoid that person.
Yeah.
Try to get around them as fast as possible.
Be like close to those things.
Yeah. So I don't know. Rest in peace, person who lost their life because of somebody's stupidity.
Yeah, it's very sad.
It helps us start the day with warmth and vigor.
Me plus cake. Marconi One. Radio for the people.
Found this pretty awesome website that Sierra Cake and I are going to try. And this isn't a commercial.
I want to sign up right now.
This is genuinely something we get excited about. Like when we find these little
snacks!
Websites.
Snacks!
Yeah, it's called graze.com, and it basically has like these little healthy snacks. Mm-hmm. And what's all in this
there's
website?
Like savory snacks, there's just like fruit bits, there's like fruit and chocolate mixes.
Oh yeah.
There's like seed, like trail mixes.
Man, it looks delicious.
So, I just want it right now.
And a whole box is just $6 and it includes shipping.
Yes.
So how fast does that come to you?
Like 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
I know, it takes a long time.
Oh my gosh.
Hey, it's free shipping, so
I would how much would you pay for shipping then?
Like
$10?
Well, it depends where it comes from.
Oh, my gosh. Well, I would definitely pay for the shipping if it meant that.
No, because you get it like a couple times a month.
Oh, I see. Oh, okay.
And then you can change it so that you get it maybe only once a month. Or
like if you don't like it, then you don't have to sign. You can bow out of it.
You can cancel anytime, yeah.
It says guilt-free snacking, so I guess that means that low calorie and all that stuff.
I had a friend of mine sign up today.
Oh, you did?
Yes.
And well,
I got a coupon code.
We have to try it.
I know. I'm so excited.
It's graze.com. And this is not an advertisement. We're just, you know, sometimes you find something on
the
internet.
Where did you even find this glorious, glorious invention?
Well, I'm an internet entrepreneur and I, you know,
well,
I know a guy. He tells me about things here and there. And
black market kind of stuff.
No.
Do you know one time I got Shrek 2? Like a year before it came out in theaters.
No, don't talk. You'll go to prison.
No, I didn't get it.
No,
it was gifted to me.
That's fine if it's. But it's an illegal copy. You'll go to prison.
I don't have it anymore. I threw it away. I felt so guilty.
This is not. Destroy this whatever audio clip this is, because Sarah's too pretty for prison.
Oh God.
They met on the internet, and now they're on Marconi One. It's Me Plus Cake. Radio for the people.
Scientists may have discovered a cure for baldness.
Oh my God. And men everywhere.
Rejoice. I mean, 50% of men have balding issues.
Yes.
So,
Do you have balding issues?
That's why I wear a wig every day.
Yes.
It's more of a weave.
Yeah, it's sewn in. I can see it.
Yeah, right. It's beautiful, though, right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. There you mm-hmm. go. But I guess they've tried some stem cell treatment that helps dead hair follicles grow again. And I don't know. Previously, scientists struggled to create enough follicle generation for stem cells to produce noticeable hair growth. But now they've implanted mice with special stem cells, which regenerated in two different types of skin cells in their hair follicles, allowing hair to grow again. So before you know it, we'll all have rat hair.
Ew.
You know how people say you have a rat, your hair looks like a rat's nest? Well, that could be true.
Oh, my God. It was like foreshadowing. The Illuminati planned all this.
Yes, it's all the la-la-la-la-la.
Yep.
I'm not in it. Obviously, I can't even say it.
Me plus cake. Marconi One. Radio for the people.
It is a pleasant spur to the morning's work.
A man in New Zealand fights off a shark, then stitches himself up, has a beer at the bar, then goes to the hospital.
Huh.
Yeah. I guess he and his buddies were, you know, spear fishing or something off the coast of New Zealand. And then he felt this tug on his leg, and he thought it was his buddies screwing around with him. And it was a shark, and he looked down and saw blood. And then because he's a junior doctor, he stitched himself up and went and had a beer. I would be so freaked out. I guess I'd probably want a beer, too.
Sharks scare me so bad.
Have you had any close encounters with animals like that before?
I had a pet gerbil once, and I put my hand in the thing because you're supposed to, like, let them come to you.
Right.
And it, like, ran across the cage and bit my finger and, like, wouldn't let go. And I, like, freaked out and pulled my hand up, and it was, like, still hanging on.
Oh.
And I, like, flung it, and it went, like, flying down into the cage.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Well, and then that gerbil lived outside for the rest of its days.
No, that was the first one.
Oh. But this guy, I don't know, like, sharks freak me out. And, like, I would love to swim in natural waters, but sharks, just there's too
their
many.
Their teeth.
Yeah, everything.
Ugh.
I mean, and you think, like, you know, they just sneak up on you, I guess, apparently. This guy didn't even know.
Just sneak on right up at you. Yeah.
Like, what the hell?
Marconi Bologna. Sierra Cake. Me plus Cake. Marconi One. Radio for the people.
L.A. may be the first city in the U.S. to implement age restriction on energy drink purchases.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. I don't drink energy drinks myself.
Ooh,
but
no,
I know a lot of people that do, and it just seems like a lot of sugar.
And a lot of caffeine
mixed
and, like,
together.
Stimulants.
No, and some people, you know, I guess, I don't know, what's the point? Is it just because it's bad for them that they don't want them to get in? I mean, they'll do an energy drink instead of eating breakfast sometimes. But do you think the government stepping in and saying you have to be at least 18 to drink
is going to... Yeah, that's gross. You're going to get heart conditions and stuff like that.
So what, then you have to just get an 18-year-old to buy your energy drinks
for
you?
They're going to be bootlegging.
They'll be standing outside the 7-Eleven.
Is that what it's called, bootlegging?
No.
Getting someone to boot liquor and cigarettes?
No, like if you
and
ask
energy
somebody
drinks.
Outside... What, I don't even know what that...
It's called, like, getting someone to boot for you.
Oh, it is?
I don't know if it's short for bootlegging.
Was vomiting.
What?
Yeah, he just had to boot.
No, like, my sister on New Year's was like, oh, yeah, we spent, like, the whole night trying to find her friends.
Oh, now trying you're outing to find your
sister? No, she didn't. She didn't do it, but her friends
your
all wanted...
Your a good girl still?
Yeah, they're like, oh, we were trying to find someone to boot for us. And I was like, oh, my God, I haven't heard that saying since I was, like, 14.
I've heard, when it comes to Canada, a boot, but I've never heard booting. But yeah, so now you'll have to stand around going, hey, bro, I know, hey, could you buy a case of energy drinks for me and my friends, bro?
Yeah, they're going to do that.
And then somebody's going to prison.
I always had kids at this one gas station I would go to asking me to buy them, like, cigars and stuff, and I was like, no.
You never did it?
No. Oh, okay. Never. I would never, ever, ever.
What are you in
for? The only time that I've ever done something like that was for my friend, and he was going to a house party, and he wasn't of legal age, and he asked me to buy him
alcohol. Again, you're telling things that are illegal.
He's legal now.
Yeah, but you're saying things.
So it's just confessions. This is like a confessional. I feel so open.
I guess so. Well, will you go buy me some energy drinks, by the way?
No.
You should have heard him this morning.
Me plus Kate. Marconi One. Radio for the people.
I'm kind of excited because, as you know, I've moved almost every year of my high school existence.
Yes.
So I don't have a ton of long-term friends. Like, I didn't keep in touch with them.
You have no friends. It's okay. I understand.
I'm really awful at that. How dare you? And as you can imagine, like, over the years, like, you know, when they pop up and you see them on Facebook and you kind of rekindle your friendship, it's kind of cool.
Yes.
So I may appreciate it more than most people because, like I said, there's not a lot of longtime friends that I have from high school. And my friend Brenda, who I was friends with her when I was 17, mm-hmm. and I lived in Sheraton, Iowa.
Oh, my.
With my aunt. Mm-hmm. And it was kind of the coolest thing ever because my mom and I had a falling out, and I moved to Iowa for the summer, and then I stayed there for a couple of school years. And Brenda was my buddy, my BFF.
Yes.
And we hung out all the time. And now she's like a PhD. She's a doctor.
Mm-hmm.
And she's going to an interview at a college here locally. And she's like, hey, you got to show me around. And I'm like, oh, wow. She told me it's been 25 years since we've seen each other.
I'm not even 25 years old. I haven't been even alive for that long.
I have a friend that's older than your life, a friendship with someone.
Oh, God.
Oh.
Does that make you feel old? Sorry.
Wow. Anyway, so I'm pretty excited. And I'm excited for you to meet her, too, because she's a really cool person.
When is she getting here?
I don't know yet. I'll have to check that out. But she wants, you know, like, it's a town near here.
Mm-hmm.
And she's going for an interview at this college. I don't know if she's going to be a professor or what she does. I don't even know. I know she's a doctor. And I'm like, oh, cool. One of my friends from high school is a doctor now. You know, like, but that just means, like, you're whatever field you're in, you have the highest level of education, right? I mean, she's not a medical doctor, that's for sure.
No, but she would still be called doctor.
Right.
Something.
So do I get to call her by her name, Brenda? Or do I have to call her Dr. Brenda now?
Yeah.
I do?
Yes.
It's like royalty? That's like Sir Paul McCartney?
Yeah, like on, like in letters and stuff, you're not like Mrs. or Miss anymore or Mr. You're doctor.
How cool is that?
I know. Well, but it takes like years to get those things.
25, apparently.
Yes.
Marconi plus Sierra is
me plus Kate.
Only on Marconi One.
Radio for the people.
Oh, man. I don't like ending podcast, but we have to do it, or what? I mean, we can't stay here forever, right?
'Cause we put on quite a show.
Really had you going.
Blow.
I've gotten a couple of messages, people telling us they like our little close with Rihanna.
I know, it's so good.
I know. But ties right in. It wraps things up quite emotionally.
I know, it makes everyone depressed.
No, it doesn't. they're sad because we're gone for another day.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
But just start the podcast from the beginning again then.
I mean, listen to it over and over and over
until you have it memorized, and then I would love for somebody to mimic one of our podcasts and see how that goes.
Mm.
Yeah, try it. Let us know. Well, you know, maybe there's something in it for you. If you don't follow us on the social medias, please do. Everything at MePlusCake. MePlusCake. I spelled it for people in case they didn't know. You can't just put the plus symbol in there.
No.
You have to use the word plus.
Yes.
People might get confused. I don't know. All kinds of internet things happen. Or for all the links, MePlusCake.com. For my lovely girlfriend / future dream lady. But that sounded weird. Well, you have a promise ring. So what you're... promise to be the future Mrs. Marconi.
Oh, God.
Sierra Cake. We bid you adieu until next time.
Oh, am I leaving now?
Yeah, get out. Just,
okay, see ya.
Get out!
But you put on quite a show. Really had me going. But now it's time to go. Curtains finally closing. That was quite a show. Very entertaining.